su pergale ir ar viskas vyko pagal jūsų planą šiandien?
Na ne, gal vėlgi pradžia tokia šiek tiek ne tokia, kokia norėtumėm žaidžiant namie ir mes suprantam, kad ta šiokia tokia persvara, nu ne šiokia tokia, ta persvara kažkiek tai įlenda į galvas ir atrodo, kad turim tiesiog gal lengviau žaisti ir viskas bus gerai. Tai iš tikrųjų šiek tiek va tas neramino, bet ta koncentracija su kiekvienu kėliniu gerėjo ir iš tikrųjų džiaugiamės, kad visi gavo minučių pažaisti ir apsijom be traumą, aišku, labai užjaučiu Kėdainius, daug žaidėjų krenta, bet čia vėlgi turbūt turim suprasti, jie žaidė prieš 48 valandas rungtynės. Tai čia šiais laikais, kai komandos byra ir nesportuoja dėl COVID, pandemijų ir taip toliau, tai pavojinga, žiauriai pavojinga iš tikrųjų žaisti per tokį trumpą laiką, bet stiprybės Kėdainiam, o mes, aišku, džiaugiamės patekę į kitą etapą.
Arvydas Šikšnius šiandien sugrįžo, tarsi nebūtų 2 mėnesius nežaidęs, kaip jo pasirodymas nuo pat pirmų minučių. Pirmas išėjimas į aikštelį iš karto užtikrintai atrodo, kad jokios pauzės tarsi nebūtų buvę.
Gerai, labai džiaugiamės dėl Arvido ir jam svarbu buvo įeiti gerai rungtynės, jis tą padarė. Tas minutės limitavom, nenorėjom šiandieną irgi daug apkrauti jo, bet mums kiekvienas žmogus svarbus ir tas Arvido kaip kapitono, ypač tas grįžimas ir žaidėjom dadeda tokį vienybės, stiprybės jausmą. Tai džiaugiamės dėl jo ir su kiekvienom rungtynėm tikimės vis to produktyvesnio, geresnio ir ilgesnio minučių laiko.
Daug žaidė jaunimas šiandieną, pakankamai daug, Laurynas Balkūnas, šiek tiek mažiau, bet irgi žaidė Redas Venslovas, Robertas Indrišiūnas. Apie Balkūną galbūt geriausios jo gal net karjeros oficialios rungtynės, ar toks jo pasirodymas leidžia tikėtis, jog šitas žaidėjas gali dar labiau praplėsti Pasvalio rotaciją, ar šiandien jis užsidirbo papildomai minučių?
Tai vat norėjau pasakyti, būtent paskutintas sakinys buvo teisingiausias, jisai ne tai, kad parodė gerą žaidimą, jisai užsitarnavo užsirekomendavo gauti ateinančius rungtynėse minučių ir taip toliau. Tai vėlgi tai čia pas mus visiems iš tikrųjų per treniruotės pasirodo, kaip kas pasiruošė rungtynėm, pagal tai sprendė rungtynių minutės ir taip toliau. Tai Laurino darbų neturim nusiskundimų, kad liečia treniruotės, tikrai drąsėja, aišku, jam tos drąsos reikia, vėlgi žaidžiant oficialias rungtynės, bet šiandien mes tikrai džiaugiamės dėl jo ir teisingai sako, jisai užsirekomenduoja.
Žinau, kad nepasakysit, kuris varžovas būtų parankiausias ketvirtfinalyje, taip paprastai treneriai garsiai nešneka, bet turit nusižiūrėjęs bent jau prieš tą sekmadienio burtų traukimo ceremoniją oponentą, kurio pavadinimą prie savęs pamatė, sakytumėt, nu, čia mums gerai, mums tinka.
Ne, turbūt ne, žinot, tai visi kalba apie Neptūno susilpnėjimą šiemet, mes žaisim už 5-6 dienų vėl su Neptūnu, pralaimėjom ten rungtynės, su Lietkabeliu žaidėm vienas, pralaimėjom rytą, iš tų komandų vienintelį esam nugalėję, tai ar sakyt, kad rytą rinktis, nu, irgi ne, tai faktas turbūt visi norim išvengti Žalgirio. Tai yra, vėlgi, tai yra visiškai neįžeidžiant kitų komandų, vis tiek aukštesnis lygis yra. Tai, o toliau, kai bus, tai bus, tai kad ir bus Žalgiris, reikės pirmiausia bandyti nuteikti kovą ir kautis, o daugiau pasirinkdėje negalim.
Ačiū. You know, I'm just very proud of our effort. Obviously, we get off to a great start. You know, Ariel was incredible in the first few minutes. You know, we knew going into the game we could only play him with a minutes restriction. Same with Jakubas, the new point guard. So both those guys were really a bright spot, good bright spot, just that we were on a minutes restriction with those guys. But I thought we played a great first half. We were right there. We were battling. We were in the game. You know, a lot of things went wrong for us. Domantas, when he hurt his ankle, this was very bad for us because he's a very good young player. He was having a great game. He started out, he hit a three, and he was really playing good. So when he hurt his ankle, that hurt us. Then Ariel, we didn't want to risk, you know, putting him back in the second half. It's nothing major. He just knocked knees, so he's okay. But we don't want to risk. So then once he went out, and Martinez, another one of our wing guards, got a little dizzy, so he couldn't play. So our numbers just kept going down. It went from 10 to 8 to 6 to finally finish the game with 5 guys. So after a while, I knew that eventually, they're a very good team. You know, we respect them. I mean, they beat us at home, I believe, with Cedric playing and Abramo both playing in the game, and they beat us there. and then tonight we didn't have those two besides all the other injuries. So we knew that it was going to be a hard game on the road, and they're a very good team. We had to go zone out of necessity because of how many bodies and our foul trouble and all this. And that's scary against a team like this when they're at home, because eventually I figured the dam was going to break and they were going to make some threes. Unfortunately, we went 2 for 24 from three, which is, you know, I think it's 8%. So if you go 2 for 24 from three in a game on the road and shoot 8% from three, it's almost impossible to win this game. I mean, it's just impossible. Like, you can't go 8% from three against a good team and their building, you know? So a lot of things went wrong in the second half. I don't think the score was really indicative of the game. We end up losing by 20, but I didn't feel like it was a 20-point game. Again, take my hat off to the other team. They're a smart team. They play very well together. They share the ball. I thought that Tomulis and Kaza, our two veterans, gave us some, you know, some good veteran leadership. Chappas, all the guys that have been here, you know, they kind of carried us through, because, again, this is a tough kind of game to be part of. You know, it was like a tale of two halves. The first half is like a game we could win. The second half is like a game we had no chance. So this was hard.
Wow, coach, it's such an interesting to listen to you. Now I understand why Virginijus Bulotas called you as one of the best speakers in the history of Lithuania. Amazing, coach.
I do talk very fast. I'm from New York. I'm sorry for this.
Yeah.
I hope you understand my...
Yeah, of course. Coach, just one question I have about Ariel Hukporti. This prospect played just a few minutes, but how do you like his performance, especially the energy at the beginning of the game? How did you like it?
Well, I thought it was incredible. I mean, none of us, we all weren't sure. We knew he was okay to play. We thought maybe he was going to be a little nervous, you know, in his wind, you know, his conditioning. So we didn't expect him to come out and, you know, steal the ball and get a windmill dunk and a three. And the only thing we need to talk to him about a little bit is he lost his emotions a little there when he got a foul and he got a technical. You know, we need to work with him on this. He's got to control his emotions and you know, learn to handle this. But other than that, I mean, he was great. I mean, you know, I'm happy that it was nothing serious, because we didn't really want to risk. We just want to bring him back slowly, you know, each game, maybe play a little more minutes than the next time. But he's got great potential. You know, NBA scouts and people know about him. There's not many 7-foot guys that with his body at age 18 that have his skill set walking around. So he has a very big future potential. Great talent, great potential.
And the last one question, coach, is it possible to you to stay as a head coach of the team till the end of the season?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, I haven't even discussed this with the this decision is, you know, for the owners and Virgis, our general manager, and them to make. I came, you know, specifically to be in a certain role, to work with the Ariel and those guys, try to help get him ready for the NBA. And so I think that, you know, they're going to really look and think about, maybe do they want to bring in a veteran, a foreign coach who's been around for a long time coaching over here. And, you know, since I've only been to the LKL for 12, 13 games. So, you know, I don't have this really in my mind right now about politicking or something like this. Right now, this is the decision for the owners, and they'll make a good decision, because they're good people. They know what they're doing. And, you know, I'm just I told the guys I'm honored to have been their coach even for just the last two games, because they gave everything they have, you know. Like I said, the score, you know, I'm not happy. I'm a competitor. I don't want to go 0-2, but I'd rather take the losses than the team, because they don't deserve, these guys. You know, they like really are, they deserve to win, the team.
Thank you, coach.
Okay. Thank you.